Welcome to the video news of the week. On Monday of this week, the Indian Stream Health Center in Colebrook held a ribbon cutting for its newly renovated and expanded facility.
Ta-da!
Ta-da!
The ribbon cutting was followed by a tour of the upper and lower levels of the center.
It's going to be very flexible furniture because we're going to...
We spoke with CEO Shirley Powell.
I have to pinch myself. It doesn't seem possible that 3 years ago we were struggling, and then to get to this point is absolute testimony, I think, to the staff and board of this organization. The total expansion is 4,200 square feet. That includes upstairs and downstairs. And that's about half, a little bit less than half, of what the facility, the older facility, which is somewhat over 9,000. And it allowed us to have some room for growth. We were absolutely, you know, packed into rooms with five and six people in a very small area. So it, you know, the expansion really represents a more appropriate space for certain functions.
The health center has launched a capital campaign. Members of the Capital Campaign Committee spoke with us about the fundraising efforts.
The Capital Campaign, the total funds that we have projected we need to complete the renovation and the expansion is $888,000. The cost of this area that you have seen today is really was the $700,000. Actually went a little above it.
We established a Capital Campaign Committee made up of board members, staff, and community members as well, users of the facility. So it's a great blend of individuals.
Things that are being done with the community's funds are things like a generator for backup electricity, some work on the fire alarm system, furnishing for the reception areas and the community room, and many things that actually serve the community.
So I think it's important for people to understand that by supporting Indian Stream Health Center, they're also supporting the hospital, for instance, because we're the ones who, you know, refer to the hospital, if supporting the tax base of the communities, supporting local businesses because we employ local people.
It's been pretty successful thus far. The projects, or the capital campaign, is just a couple of months underway. We're looking to kick it into full gear here in the next month or so. So we're excited about it. It's a great opportunity.
The fifth annual TubaChristmas was held last Saturday at Trinity United Methodist Church in Colebrook. It brought together tubas, baritones, and euphoniums from around northern New England and Quebec for the annual blast of Christmas tunes. The event is sponsored by the Great North Woods Committee for the Arts.
On Sunday, the Monadnock Congregational Church was host to the 15th annual Christmas Music Festival, which featured a performance of Handel's Messiah. Solo and choral numbers were performed, spotlighting the wide range of local talent.
Joyful and
Academy lit up the night during its annual winter concert last week under the direction of Misty Renard. Students performed a variety of holiday numbers. Monday night, Stratford School held their winter concert. Chronicle reporter Charlotte Sheltry provided this video of the event, which was under the direction of Molly Tobin.
The Ministerium held its annual Colebrook Kiwanis Memory Tree lighting ceremony on Saturday morning in front of the Colebrook Public Library. Pastor Rebecca Larson provided opening words for the ceremony.
I want to welcome everybody here to the, I don't know what, how many annual Tree of Love ceremony this is. My paper says 1998, so it's been a while, and it's a really remarkable thing where you can come and change a red light bulb to a clear light bulb and have it be in memory of somebody. So this is a wonderful thing. The Kiwanis is a wonderful organization, and most of what they do benefits children. So how can you go wrong at Christmas time when you're benefiting children and remembering somebody you love? So welcome here today.
Thank you.
That's with wisdom, patience, and courage. They may minister in His name to the suffering, the friendless, and the needy.
The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be amongst you and remain with you always.
Amen. Amen.
Groveton Elementary School students and staff participated in the 6th annual food drive this past week. A chain of students passed food from the school to the local food pantry. Chronicle reporter Charlotte Sheltry reports from the event.
The Groveton Elementary School has a food chain with children passing one item to each other all the way from the school to the Catholic rectory.
The North Country lost one of its most beloved musical voices this past week with the passing of Carolyn Brooks. Carolyn and her husband, Brad, headed a group of area musicians known as Carolyn and Friends, who shared their musical gifts with countless appreciative audiences around the region for many years. The video news of the week remembers Carolyn Brooks.
The old hometown looks the same as he steps down from the train.
It's a good time to stay indoors around the Christmas tree. Expect flurries and snow showers on Friday. On Christmas Day, brace for a high of 18 and a low of 9. Sunday ends the weekend with a high of 17 and a low of 10, with partly cloudy skies. In sports news, Groveton High School senior Kelly Collins was recognized for scoring her 1,000th career point in basketball during a game last Monday. She is seen here receiving the award from Groveton coach Tim Haskins. In basketball, the Colebrook girls faced off against Woodsville last Friday. Canaan played in Pittsburgh in these games last week.
Oh, you got three now!
Happy holidays from all of us at the Colebrook Chronicle and the Video News of the Week.